It is a lovely thing to have Jesus pray for you. It is a lovely thing to have Jesus praying for us. And that is what he did in the gospel. And that doesn't stop there. Actually, he prays for us every time. So if we are with him, we are his children, he prays for us. He never leaves us out of his prayer. So you heard him saying in that beautiful prayer to his father, he always mentions the apostles, his people. Every line was mentioning them, especially asking God to be their support, their strength, to be their guide. You see, Jesus always gives us that support. He doesn't leave us alone. He doesn't leave us as orphans. He gives us a support. He prays for us. The next time you are praying for yourself, remember that Jesus has already prayed for you. And when Jesus prays for you, and when Jesus is praying for us, you are sure that you are secured. You are safe. Amen. Amen. My dear friends, the first reading, we hear that 120 men and women met to pray. If we are going to chapter 1, we read from chapter 1, verses 15. But from chapter 1 before the verses 15, we hear that these 120 men and women included the mother of God. His Mary was there. So you see, when we are having Pentecost Novena, Mary was there. When prayer was being offered, Mary was there. And that is why in a church, see, whenever we are praying, we know that Mary accompanies us. So when we pray and we ask her to add a voice to our prayers, it's because the first prayer of the apostles, gathering in prayer for 9 days prayer before the Holy Spirit, Mary was there with them. When prayer was needed, she was there. The next time you need prayer, remember that she's always there when we are praying. So she was there, quietly, but she was there. And she stands for all women. Today is Mother's Day. Mothers, let us learn from this woman, who is your example, the mother of all mothers, Mother Mary. She loved to pray. May mothers here and everywhere love to pray. Amen. Amen. Lift your family, lift your husband, lift your children, those who are taken care of. Every day you pray, lift them to God's hands. Because the prayers of mothers are so precious to God. We pray that God himself will be your support, your strength, mothers, to make you become better mothers. See, anytime we have Mother's Day, actually, we're reminding you that, are you a good mother? Well, as a Mother's Day, you have to examine yourself. It's a call to be a better mother each year. Now, in that campaign of 120, we hear that Peter stood up and said that, let us do something. We need a replacement. God is the last replacement. The apostles were 12, but somehow one of them had left. Judas, you know the story. He betrayed Jesus. And after that, he hung himself, and then he died. So there were 12, but the number reduced to 11. And then Peter said they have to restore the number to 12. So this is called the last replacement. In this last replacement, they needed someone to replace Judas. So what happens? They did two things. First, they did what humans would do, and number two, they did what God would do. So there's the human criteria and the divine criteria. Let's look at the human criteria. So the human criteria is that Peter stood up and said, they want someone who has been with them from the time Jesus was baptized to the time he was taken to heaven. That is for all the 3 years. All the 3 years of Jesus' life, the person might have been there. But we know that when Jesus was choosing his 12 disciples, apostles, so it means that this person was there from the beginning. But I know some of us are like this man, Matthias. Now we know his name. The first shortlist, you miss it. The first selection, you miss it. And for some of us, when we miss the first selection, we want to give up. Matthias missed the first selection of Jesus for the 12. When Jesus needed the 12 apostles, he was there. But Jesus didn't pick him. Somehow it missed him. And yet, this man kept following Jesus. Why are you following Jesus? Is it because you want him to select you? Is it because you want him to give you something? How about if that thing misses you? Will you continue following him? Mothers, this is our example. Women, men. This man, though he missed the criteria of Jesus when he had 12 apostles, he kept following him. He said, okay, Jesus, if I wanted a child, Jesus, if I wanted a husband, Jesus, if I wanted a wife, and then it has missed me, I will not stop following you. I'm still following you. See, they were driven by something beyond just something physical. But don't forget, every Matthias will have his divine day. Amen. I say every Matthias will have his divine day. Amen. So for 3 years, he was there. He's never mentioned. And yet, when Jesus had gone up to heaven, they needed someone to replace Judas. That's where he comes to the scene. That he was there quietly. We pray for the Matthias amongst us. They are staying there. They are there also. Nobody knows their names. They are not counted. They are not church presidents or PPC chairmen. They are not leaders in the choir. They are not leaders in the lectures. They are not leaders in the at mass service. They are not leaders amongst priests and religious. Yet they are the Matthiases we have around. Quietly, they are following in the footsteps of Christ. So that is the Matthias for you. Now, listen to the criteria. When they ask for somebody who has been there from the beginning to the end, they had two people. The first person is called Joseph. That Joseph had a nickname. It says, Joseph, nicknamed Barsabbas. Hello? Christ the King. They knew his name. Even they knew what his nickname. His AKA Barsabbas. And then they said, and surnamed Justus. So the first person they had on the list, they knew his name, they knew his nickname, they knew his surname. It tells you, my dear sisters, my dear brothers, that this man was the most popular. To the extent that they knew his nickname, some of you here, I don't know your nicknames. I also have a nickname, how you are aware? The priest will tell me. You don't know because you don't know me that much, you know my nickname. So for you to know my AKA, my nickname, my other name, means that I'm quite known to you. And then not that, they knew his surname. So he was the number one of the slot. He was a favorite. The word is favorite. He was the likely candidate. The likely replacement was put there, number one. And then they need a second person, put a name, Matthias. No nickname, no surname. They don't know much about him. He has always been quiet there, so Matthias was added. So that is the human criteria. See, the next time you want to make a decision in life, my dear sisters, my dear brothers, don't forget this. Don't expect God to bring a husband to you, a wife to you in your bed. It will not happen. He needs your human criteria. Don't expect to be in your bedroom and get a job. It will not happen. He needs your human criteria. What can you offer? What can you do for yourself? Bring that on board. So it's only after they had brought what they can offer to God, that they leave it to God. They left it to God. So when you have done all you should do as to get a job, to get a partner, to then leave it to God at the doorstep of God. So the second thing is that they left it at the doorstep of God. Now this is how they voted. I don't know that I'm going too far because of time. They had two names. They wrote, in those days, how they made the elections. They'll write the names, like as we do the ballot, the names, two names. Matthias and then Joseph Barsabbas Justus. So two names. And then they put the two names in their container and shake them like that. They shake them so hard that one of them has to drop to the ground. So the name that will drop out of the box or the container on the ground, on the floor, since they didn't force that paper to come out, they said that's what God has chosen. And that day, my sisters, my brothers, the unpopular man, the silent man, the unfavored, the less favored person, his name dropped. So when they went to open the paper, they said, Matthias, say, come, you are the one God wants. Maybe you are Matthias listening to me. Today, God will choose you. Maybe in your marriage, you become a Matthias. Things are not happening, you married, no children, so you are just there, you are not mentioned. Your Matthias moment will come. Amen. Maybe even in your family, you are seen as a Matthias. When they are calling you in the family, they don't mention you. This is Matthias. God chose him even though he was not popular. And then they mentioned him, Matthias. They added him to a number. Now we know him as one of the 12 apostles. God will make him known someday. Amen. It's the popularity of God that we are looking for. It's the favor of God, not human favor, not human popularity. Acclamation, but the acclamation of God. So if you listen carefully, you know, this man was destined to replace Judas. So he became one of the 12. Let me end the homily with the last thing. He was chosen to be a witness to the resurrection. It sounds in the Greek, a martyriates anastasis autun. A witness. You know, a witness is somebody who is a martyr, you know, somebody who can give his life for the resurrection. I pray that as mothers, when you give your life always the last drop for your children, love them, love them, love them. And your children also love their mothers. I pray that God will give mothers everything they need to become the best of mothers. Martyriates anastasis autun. Giving of everything, everything in your capacity. And not just mothers, all of us here. If you're a father, you're a daughter, a son, a child, whatever position you have, this is your witness. A witness is somebody who gives in everything. He puts in everything. She puts in everything. A maturia, a witness, a martyr. May God help us. Like Matthias, who has now become a role model, to work quietly, even if you are not recognized. And not give up, even if you are not selected at the first chance. Because in the second moment, the Matthias moment will come your day soon. Amen.